What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going over how to install Minecraft Forge client-side. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all of our future videos. Everyone loves a good vanilla Minecraft game, but for a lot of people, the game just isn't the same without adding some type of mods. While you might think you can just throw the mods into a mods folder and hop in, it actually isn't that simple. You're going to have to run the Minecraft Forge version through your Minecraft launcher to get them to work. Mods give you the chance to bring your game to a whole new level, adding new items, mobs, and more. And with how simple it is to install Forge, you'll be able to get started in no time at all. Unfortunately, Forge only works with the Java edition of the game, so make sure to keep that in mind before deciding if this tutorial is right for you. First, you're going to visit the official Minecraft Forge website that will be linked down below. In the left-hand menu, find the Minecraft version you want to use, and then once that's selected, you can click on the installer button for either the latest or the recommended version. After this downloads, save the file to an easily accessible place because we will need it in just a minute. If you're looking for a specific version of Forge that you don't see in the latest or recommended options, then you're going to want to press the Show All Versions button for a list of all of the available version releases, and then you can choose the installer option from there. Next, we're going to have to open up that new file, which means having the latest version of Java installed. So head to that Minecraft Forge jar file and open it. In the new window, make sure the install client is selected, and then make sure your directory is headed towards the .minecraft folder and press OK. After a few moments, you should receive a successful install message. For macOS, you're going to find your Forge jar file and open it. If the file can't be opened, enter System Preferences in the top left, followed by Security and Privacy. In the General section, find the app and press Open Anyway, and once it's open, make sure the install client is selected, check that the directory is going to the right place, and then press OK, and in a few moments, you should get a successful install message. Now that you have Forge downloaded, you should be ready to select your Forge profile. If your launcher was running before you installed Forge, shut down and restart the launcher, and then it should load up. If the profile isn't appearing, head to the Installations tab at the top, and then click on the modded box next to the right-hand side. After that, head back into the main launcher page and make sure Forge is selected, and then you can press play to start your game. Another option is to download and use the CurseForge app to install and use Forge. This app allows you to install any version of Forge with just a few clicks, simplifying the setup. Download and install the CurseForge app for your operating system, and then in that app, you can press the Create Custom Profile button. Enter your chosen name and Minecraft version, and then select the game type Forge and select the game version that you need. Press Create to complete the setup process, and then you can select your new custom profile and press Play. If you want to try mods on your Minecraft server, Forge is going to be your gateway. With Forge, you can install as many mods as you want, leaving your gameplay up to nothing but your imagination. Just remember that with mods, anyone using the server has to have them installed, which means them installing Forge too. So make sure to share this video with a friend, and as always, gamers, we hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.